Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2150, VLOOKUP, each Alt+Entered value in each cell. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, one of the more bizarre questions. Someone said, hey, I want to do a VLOOKUP for each value in the cell. And when I opened the Excel file, the data has been Alt+Entered. So there's four items in this order, and they're all separated by Alt+Enter, and then only two here, and six here, and so on. I went back to the person who sent this in. It's like, well, this is a really bad way to store this data. Why are you doing this? And they're like, I'm not doing it. This is the way that the data is downloaded. I said, is it okay if I split it out into separate rows? No, you need to keep it this way. All right, so there's no good way to do a VLOOKUP for each individual item. And tomorrow, on tomorrow's episode, 2151, I'm going to show you how we can use a brand new feature in Power Query to do this, but you'd have to have Office 365 to have that. So today I'm going to use a method that's going to go all the way back. And what I've done here is I've created a new worksheet with the lookup table. So these are the items. I also noticed that there's a whole bunch of things. About 40% of the things here aren't in the lookup table. I said, what do you want to do there? And no response to that question. So I'm just going to leave them as they are if I don't find a match. All right, so what I have here is I have a sheet called lookup table, and you'll see that my file right now is stored as xlsx, and I'm going to use a VBA macro. In order to use a VBA macro, you can't have it as xlsx. It's against the rules. So you have to save as, and say this is xlsm file, save as, and change it from a workbook to either a macro-enabled workbook, xlsm, or a binary workbook. Either one of those will work. All right, and click save. All right, so now we're allowed to run macros. Alt F11 to get to the macro recorder. You start out with this big gray screen, insert module, and there's our module. And here's the code. So I call it replace in place, and I define one worksheet that's the lookup table. You'd put your real lookup table worksheet name there. And then my lookup table starts in column A, which is column 1. So I go to the very last row in column 1, press the N key and the up arrow, or of course control up arrow would do the same thing. Figure out what row it is. And then we're going to go from every row from 2 to final row. Why 2? Well, because the headings are in row 1. So I want to replace starting in row 2 all the way down to the last row. And so for each row from 2 to final row, the from value is what's in column A, and the to value is what's in column B. Now, if for some reason your data was in J and K, then this J would be the 10th column, so you put a 10 there, and K would be the 11th column. And then in the selection, we're going to replace the from value to the to value. This is really important here, XL part, and that's an L, not a number one, XL part, which says that we're going to allow us to replace part of the cell, because those part numbers are all separated by a line feed character. Even though you can't see it, it's there. So that should allow us to not accidentally update the wrong thing. And then XL by rows, match case false, search format false, replace format false, next I. All right, so this is our little macro here. Let's try it. We'll take this data, and I don't want to destroy anything, so I'm just going to take the original data and copy it over to the right. All right, so we have our selection there. Actually, I'm going to start from this point. Control backspace, and then Alt F8 to get a list of all the macros. There's our replace in place. I'll click run, and everywhere that it found an item in the lookup table, it replaced that item number with the item, seemingly doing a VLOOKUP, although we're not solving it with a VLOOKUP at all. All right, so hey, the brand new book that came out, Power Excel with Mr. Excel, the 2017 edition, 617 Excel mystery solved, all kinds of great new tips in there. Today's wrap up, viewer downloads data from a system where each item is separated by an Alt+Enter and then needs to do a VLOOKUP at each item. And you know, like, why am I doing this? So the person said, I'm not doing it, but I need to keep it this way. And then 40% of the values that not on the table, well, no answer. So I guess they're going to add those items to the table. Now tomorrow we're going to talk about how to solve this with Power Query, but today this macro will work all the way back in all Windows versions of Excel, going back to Excel 2007 at least. So instead of a VLOOKUP, just a series of find and replace with VBA. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.